welcome to Radiant Heart Yoga. This is a yin practice for soothing the lower back. In my classes, I get a lot of requests for back problems. So we're going to do some really nice stretches to open up the sides of the waist, which is important when there's lower back issues, and to just create some space in that area of the lower back. Open up the hips a little bit and just release everything around there. So you're going to, I've got my incense lit, so set yourself a really nice space. See if you can choose a time to do the video where you're not going to be disturbed. Put some nice music on and let's get started. So the only prop you should need, you might need a brick or and a blanket. So we're going to start at the back of your mat, or maybe about the middle of your mat, bringing your big toes together, knees nice and wide. We're going to come into child's pose. So you're going to come all the way down and bring your forehead down to the floor. So if your forehead doesn't reach the floor, this is one of the times when you can use your blanket. If it's a little bit challenging to get your hips onto your heels, you can use a blanket underneath your thighs and a brick to rest your head on. So always use your props. You want your pose to be as relaxing as possible. And from here, a little bit of movement before we settle in for our yin long hold of stillness. So you're just going to just roll across your forehead, feeling how that transfers into the hips, as though you're being swayed by the movement of your breath. And then come to stillness. Take your hands around and just give your lower back, from the mid back down, just a little bit of a massage, taking your hands around to your knees and then back. And then settling in, you can have your hands back towards your feet. Gonna have your hands forwards, palms together or palms facing up. You can make a pillow to rest your head on with your arms as well if you're not using a blanket. And then settle into the stillness. Commit to the stillness. Breathing into any urges to fidget. Gradually allowing a little bit more weight to drop through the hips. Merging into the earth, gathering up that earth energy, energy of stability, coming from a stable foundation. Whether you can unravel any tension, bring your awareness to that place. And if you find anything, any gripping, any holding, can you soften and let it go? So sometimes lower back issues can be caused by a lot of stress. Emotional blockages in that area. A lot of the energy channels run through the sacrum to the lower back. Taking another 3 breaths here. Your hands and slowly start to walk way up, and then from here just sitting in to the side and swinging your legs around, a little shake out through the legs, just moving really slowly in between the poses. And then you're going to tuck your left heel in, point your left knee towards the front of your mat. Wrap your right foot around. You're going to adjust this left foot so you can get both sit bones on the floor. If you need to have something underneath this left knee and the right foot to make the pose more accessible, then you're going to do that. And then you're going to reach your right hand out to the right and sweep your left arm over and down to the floor. So I'm just going to show you on the outside edge of this right foot. You're not trying to keep the sole of the foot on the floor. And you're just going to position your hands. You can always put something underneath your hands to lift them up and make the floor closer to you. You're going to drop your chin towards your chest. Drop the weight through your hands and settle yourself in. Stretch into the upper back and the lower back and the outer hip, the right side and the inner hip, the groin on the left side. So opening up all around the lower back. To bend your elbows a little bit and come a little bit deeper. To the other side now, and you're going to let this right hip lift up. So what I'm going to do is, you're going to stay where you are. I'm just going to turn around to the front so that you can see what's going to happen on the other side. So your left foot stays down, you're going to let this right hip lift up, And you're going to come on to your forearms. So, another time when you can maybe start off with something underneath your elbows to make the pose more accessible. And then either stay there, or once you get a little bit of space opening up, then you can come back maybe all the way down to the floor. So again, you're typical with the yin pose is you're going to drop your chin towards your chest. And again, can you see that I'm on the outside edge of this right foot? I'm not trying to get the sole of the foot to come up to the floor, because that takes some of the stretch out of the lower back. I'm trying to drop this right knee across to the right. Breathing here, looking for anywhere you can soften. And once you've released as much as you can into this shape, just really relaxing into it. Just enjoying this luxurious long hold. Really working deeply into the fascia, all around the lower back, outer hip. Feeling the stretch and the broadening across your upper back as well. Finding release in the neck and the shoulders too. Keep going back to your breath. Maybe taking it a little bit further with your breath. And see if you can make your inhales and exhales equal in length. That's going to really calm and soothe your nervous system and your mind. Taking another three breaths here. On any level to the inside of your right knee, bring your right elbow to the brick and rest the right side of your head into the hand. And then take your left arm up, keep your chest open so it's a side opener, and then take your left arm alongside your ear and then reach it around to hold. And find the other hand and then drop in the weight down through your elbow, down through your sit bones, thinking about dropping your tailbone down, closing your eyes so that you can really feel the stretch. I want to think about what it looks like. As long as you've got those key actions rooting down through your sit bones, stretching through the sides of your waist, supporting your head in your hands. And we're using the hands in every pose, the hands in the palms, so we can also get into the upper body energy channels, meridian lines for the lungs and the heart. Mm-hmm. down in this position. Your other option is to take that hand behind your back. So you're not going to get quite the same stretch through the side of the waist, but you want to be able to relax your shoulders and your neck. So you choose whatever suits your body. You've just got one more minute here. Separate your feet, bend your knees, and you're going to take your hands and wrap them and hold the inside of your shins. And then round your spine, tuck your chin in, and really stretch your spine out, creating an even curve and stretch through the lower, the mid, and the upper back. And then hold the backs of your thighs as you slowly roll yourself down. And you're gonna cross your right leg over your left, and you're gonna lift your head and shoulders up and either hold your opposite knees or opposite feet. And then you're just, with your head and shoulders lifted, gonna gently rock side to side and massage out the lower back. And then lower your head down and gently take your head from side to side. And then come back to a neutral position and commit yourself to the shape, holding your feet or your knees, relaxing your shoulders, and stretching not just the lower back, but into the outer hips. So that whole area of the outer hips, the side of the waist, and the lower back can get really, really tight and create a lot of issues with the lower back. Closing your eyes. Smooth, even breath. How does your body feel now compared to at the beginning? How about your mind? Is there a little bit more space there? A little bit less clutter? Just taking another 5 breaths here. Your feet, or maybe you can bring your feet to the floor while you're still holding on to the feet. And then from here, you're going to release the left leg down and the right leg stacks on top of the left. You're going to roll to the left and press yourself up, shake your legs out. Now we're going to go the opposite way. So I'm just going to turn a little bit at an angle so you can see, but just stay facing the front. Now you're going to tuck your right heel in, point it towards the front of your mat, and then bring your left foot around and be on the outside edge of that foot. Adjust so that you've got both sit bones down on the floor. And then you're going to take your left hand out to the left and bring your right hand to the left as well. And drop your head down and find your stretch on this side. See if you can equal out the weight between your hands and even out your shoulders. Notice how this pose feels at the beginning of your time. Also, maybe any differences, subtle differences from one side of your body to the other. If you've got lower back issues, it's quite probable that there may be an imbalance of the pelvis and the hips that either resulting from it or that your lower back pain is coming because of that. So you're trying to observe whether you've got any more tightness in one side than the other. And I would recommend, as I've done on all of the yin videos, if you find that you've got one side that's much more challenging to stretch out than the other, spend more time on that side. Start to balance everything out, create more equilibrium between one side of your body and the other. Notice where you feel the stretch the most. That's going to be different for each one of us. I can really feel this just the outer hip and where the, it meets the side of the waist. That's where it's the most intense for me. So I'm going to keep taking my awareness and my breath to that place and softening as much as I can, finding what I can let go of. Taking another minute here. Maybe dropping a little bit deeper. If there's any more space for you to drop into. And then slowly pressing your way up. The legs are going to stay the same. You're going to bring this right hand around to the right. Pick up your left hip. And then bring your left hand around to the right as well. And like you did it on the other side, if you need to bring your elbows down onto a blanket or some other means of elevating your elbows up, you can do that. And then from here, as you drop into the pose, start to come more and more onto the outside edge of your foot and roll this left leg across to the left to deepen the stretch into the hip. So I'm just going to get my blanket, just because I'm on the, so I'm not going to have it very thick. I don't really want the height. I just want the comfort of not having my elbows on the hardwood floor. So again, dropping your head down. Dropping your left knee down. The other way to make it less intense is to come a little bit further across to the left. but we're all different. So for some people, that's actually going to feel more intense. So you just need to play around with a pose, find something you can relax into, but where you can still definitely feel the stretch. Taking another 5 breaths. Remember, you can always stay longer. Yourself back up. Bring your feet back in front. Again, wrap your arms underneath. Bring really nice stretch for the wrists as well. Bring your hands to hold the inside of your shins, round your spine. Tuck your chin in. Maybe a little sway. Side to side. Mm. slowly holding your thighs, rolling down, crossing your left thigh over your right. Keep your head and shoulders lifted, holding onto your knees or holding onto your feet. And gently rock side to side. Lower your head and shoulders and gently roll your head side to side. And then settle into your pose. Shoulders are relaxed. Take another three breaths here. And then slowly, either release your feet or drop your feet to the floor while you've still got hold of your feet with your hands. And then slowly just unravel your legs. Take your feet the width of your mat and gently drop your legs from side to side. And when you're sure that your lower back is okay, slide your feet out. If your lower back is a little bit tweaky after that work that you've done, then you can keep your feet nice and wide and let your knees knock together and rest here. So either or. And take your Shavasana and take as long as you can here. I'm going to leave you to enjoy your Shavasana, merging your body into the earth, releasing your breath. Thank you for sharing this practice with me. Any comments are really welcome. Subscribe to the channel, like the video. And I'll see you on the next video.